We humans have always been obsessed about space. Over 6 decades ago, the Soviets successfully placed the first artificial satellite, the Sputnik 1, in the orbit around the Earth. It was a monumental achievement, not just for the USSR, but for all of mankind. We had officially entered the space age. But the merrymaking, the wine, and the celebrations were rather short-lived. Only a few months later, the United States launched its first satellite, the Explorer 1. The scrimmage for space had begun. Soon enough, we started sending monkeys, dogs, and well, more monkeys into space. And the race for space has only gotten more intense since then.
Here, man, from the planet Earth, first set foot upon the moon, July 1969.
Fast forward to 2018, Tesla founder Elon Musk pulled off one of the most extravagant PR stunts by launching a cherry red electric sports car into space. Musk, of course, is a mad genius, and what he did was literally rocket science. While mere mortals like you and I can't send our car into space, we can surely find space in our car. Ladies and gentlemen, say hello to the 2020 Skoda Super. When speaking about space in a car, it's hard to leave the Superb out of the conversation. And you can see why. It's a car in which you can actually maintain social distancing in. Its 2841mm wheelbase makes sure of that. With the front seat set as per my position, as you can see, there's absolutely no dearth of space for my knees and my foot. But if I want to stretch my legs further and relax, I can use this boss button and push this front passenger seat further up ahead. For the comfort of the rear seat passengers, there's also an automatic climate control right here. You get sun blinds on both the rear windows and sun blinds at the back, which, by the way, are difficult to access because of the head restraints. Overall, the rear seat of the Superb is a comfortable place to be in. The seat back is well contoured. It is not very upright. It is just the right posture, and the under thigh support is quite good as well. Two passengers at the back will be absolutely comfortable. A third passenger may not be as comfortable because of the central tunnel right here, as well as the contour on the central seat. Central armrest also is a protrusion which may not be comfortable for the third passenger's back.
I also wish there was a USB port for the rear seat passengers, especially given that owners are more likely to be chauffeured around in. At the front, the overall dashboard is identical to the pre-facelift model, with the exception of the larger 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system. Although it is loaded with features like Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, navigation, and more, it does miss out on connected tech. Surprisingly, while the more affordable Sportline trim gets the virtual cockpit, this top-end LNK trim gets a semi-digital unit that is indistinguishable from the 2016 model. The Superb otherwise is still well built, and overall fit and finish is impressive too.
While most owners would prefer to take the back seat of the Superb, those who choose to take the wheel will not be disappointed at all. The first thing you would notice about the car is just how refined the motor is. There's absolutely no noise from the motor up until the 4,500 RPM mark, and even beyond that, it only lets out a mellow murmur. Under the hood is a new 2-liter TSI that replaces the old 1.8. At 188 bhp, it makes 10 horses more than before and 320 nm of torque, which is 25% more than the old 1.8. With the torque kicking in at just about 1500 rpm, the engine is quick to gain momentum, but it only comes into its element once the turbo kicks in at about 2200 rpm. In the eco mode, you may not feel the sudden rush of power because the engine is tuned to stay in the lower rev range for better efficiency. But switch to sport, and you will find that the engine isn't ill at ease even when revved hard either.
You will find yourself in the normal mode in most driving conditions, as it offers a fine middle ground of eco and sport.
The 7-speed DSG transmission shifts absolutely smoothly and is quick to respond to your inputs as well. But you will find yourself occasionally reaching out for the paddles for the want of better control, especially while making quick overtaking maneuvers.
Even in this facelifted version, the Superb's prime focus continues to be on comfort. With the monsoon in Mumbai at its peak, the state of some of the roads is almost like the surface of the moon. But the Superb evens out pretty much everything you put it through. There's no restless side-to-side movement while driving over such roads either. The soft nature of the suspension, however, has had an impact on its handling capabilities, and it doesn't feel as agile as the previous gen model. There's a fair bit of body roll when you enter hot into a corner, but once you learn to condone it, the Superb is quite predictable. At high speeds, it doesn't feel exceedingly bouncy and settles down rather quickly. The steering feels aptly weighted but could have offered more in terms of feedback. Bite from the brakes is par for the course as well. The Superb facelift continues with the design cues of the third generation model but has a few tweaked elements. Up front, the grille has been mildly reworked, and in this LNK trim gets chrome accents. The headlights have been reworked as well and are now the matrix LED kind, just like in the Audis. Skoda has also redesigned the bumpers at both ends. In the side profile, there's not much that sets this new one apart from its predecessor except for the 17-inch alloy wheels. Around the back, the taillights are all new, and instead of the winged arrow insignia, the facelift now gets Skoda lettering across the width of the boot. By and large, the Superb doesn't quite have an over-the-top design, but follows a beauty and subtlety philosophy. In a time when even more affordable cars come with connected tech, the Skoda Superb doesn't flaunt much in terms of features. In fact, this 2020 iteration isn't a colossal leap forward from the model it replaces, but it is surely greater than the sum of its parts. This new iteration looks clean and elegant, something that resonates well with its target audience. Even on the inside, the overall layout and the design is more or less similar to the model before it, but it still doesn't look dated even after all these years. All in all, the 2020 Skoda Superb does make a splash in things that matter the most, that is performance, luxury, refinement and value. On the whole, it isn't a car that will bring about a revolution or even bring sedans back into the fashion, but in everything that it stands for, it is still pretty damn superb.